Hello designers, welcome to the Vindicare. In this video, I'll be teaching you how to manipulate datum coordinate system in UGNX. Most of the automotive parts will be in a different coordinate system. So this part is provided by one of our subscriber. He has some issue with this orientation. So I'll be teaching you how to change it. Okay. I'll quickly wireframe it, and we have some ribs which is perpendicular or not perpendicular to the ejection direction. So I'll be rotating it. I'll create a datum coordinate system which is going to be absolute. Okay, absolute means this is going to be a default coordinate system. Okay, not a work coordinate, it's absolute coordinate. Okay, and I'll click OK. I'll quickly inspect how far it is, how the orientation is. Okay, based on that I'll rotate it. Okay, so first make a top view and check the how far it is. Too far. Okay, and angle also quite different. I'm not going to check angle, and I don't rotate accordingly. Okay, most of you might think I'll check angle and I'll rotate it. No, I'm not going to do so. My methods are quite different. Okay, what I do, I create a plane somewhere here with respect to the ejection direction. Okay, so if it is some square part, I'll take some three planes, but this has an inclined part, only z axis is important. So I'm making a plane where it's a z axis vector going to come. Okay, I'll show you a side view. Okay, this is quite okay. Okay, now what I do, I create another datum coordinate system here. Okay, this is my datum coordinate system. Okay, I can delete it later, not an issue. Okay, now I'll take a z axis and I'll create a x axis and a point. Okay, here I'll take any point I can take, which it should be a center of a part. Okay, but here I think there is a difficulty because this part having a lot of splitted faces. Okay, I don't want to join these faces. I'll find some way how to find a center, because if it is joint face, I can take this surface, and in this UV parameters I can take a 0.5 0.5 and I'll get center. But okay, I can take any line here. Okay, there are many lines over here. I can take some of them. Okay, in a rib, I'll take a point and a curve. Okay, I can select any curve which is going to be this is going to be my center. Okay. Okay, fine. So we got our customized datum coordinate system. Okay. So I'm going to manipulate this coordinate system with our absolute coordinate system. Okay, I'm going to take it away from offset and I'll make it center. Okay, so make sure it is associated. Okay, and unchecked associated, because if it's not, it won't move. Okay, now I'll control T, move object, and I'll select all of them. Okay, now here you can see I'm going to move it, and here I'm selecting coordinate system to coordinate system. Okay, because there is two coordinate system. So one going to be absolute. Here I made it's absolute. You can see it's a 000. The model is 00, it's absolute, and this is mine. And here what I do, I'll select just a plane which I'm going to move. Here I'll select my z axis, z plane I can move. Okay, you can move accordingly. I selected z. So this quickly moved towards the absolute, and it got aligned automatically. Okay, you can see here. Fine. So we have moved accordingly. We have not checked any angle. Okay. Now we can check its slope. I'm going to the slope checking. That is the main thing. Now we are manufacturing the mold. Draft has to be checked accordingly. So I'm checking my draft with respect to z axis, and here I'll click some point 0.3, 0.5 you can take. I selected all the faces. Okay, point minus 0.3 you select. So most of the automotive parts will be in different direction, because as per their original model they will be created, the coordinate systems. So we have to manipulate before heading to the mold design. Okay, my teacher says if the designer know how to manipulate the coordinate system, he'll be skillful. Okay, so I'll be teaching my little skill to you. Hope you learn this in further your mold design. And thank you subscriber for providing this model. This is good to communicating to each other whenever you found problems. Thank you for watching the video. Thank you.